Biodiesel can be produced from many different alcohols, but methanol is the alcohol of choice for most biodiesel producers. However, it is extremely dangerous and appropriate safety precautions must be taken with it to avoid accidents. For more details, please see Tech Note Number 8, Safety Considerations for Biodiesel, or watch the video. Typically, twice the required amount of methanol is used in biodiesel production. In order to improve efficiencies and conserve resources, producers often want to recover and reuse the excess methanol. Recovery methods can vary greatly, but the recovery process usually begins after the reaction has occurred, and the methanol is distributed between the biodiesel and the glycerol. This includes resin treatment for producers who plan to use ion exchange. The process of removing methanol from the biodiesel and glycerol can be done by evaporation, but the recovered methanol is wet and must be further refined by distillation or dried by molecular sieve in order to recycle it back into the biodiesel production process. There are several evaporation methods, including flash evaporation, thin film evaporation, and falling film evaporation. The final step in the recovery process is to dry the methanol. Separating the water from the methanol is typically done by distillation, and vacuum distillation is most commonly used in the biodiesel industry. A tall packed or stacked plate column of high separation capacity is needed. In this continuous flow situation, the liquid mixture is fed into a boiler, which sends vapors up through the column. On the way up, the vapor mixture goes through a series of condensation and vaporization cycles until the more volatile methanol is taken off from the top, and the less volatile water flows downward and is drawn off at the bottom. Before using the recovered methanol in biodiesel production, the recovered methanol should be checked for its quality. The best quality measurement is dissolved water, which can quickly be made with the Carl Fischer titrator. Learn more at biodieseleducation.org.